Hello everyone, I'm Norman Wildberger, and today we're going to be looking at another application of row reduction to the important problem of curve fitting. So this is a very simple problem that we have in front of us here. To find the quadratic function y equals a0 plus a1x plus a2x squared that passes through three given points. Point 1, 3, right here, x coordinate 1, y coordinate 3. The point 2, minus 1, x coordinate 2, y coordinate minus 1. And the point 3, 5, with x coordinate 3, y value 5. Now, generally speaking, two points will determine a line, which is a linear equation. And so it's not unreasonable to suppose that if we have three points positioned like this, that there should be a unique quadratic function that passes through them. So this turns out to be a pleasant application of linear algebra, row reduction, and it also sort of points towards interesting family of matrices called Vandermonde matrices. So let's have a look at how it looks like if we actually set up the corresponding system. So we're starting with this function here, okay? And we're going to be looking at the values when x is 1, when x is 2, and when x is 3. So we get three equations in the unknown variables a0, a1, and a2. And what are these equations? Well, the first one is that if we plug in x equals 1, we should get 3. So that's a0 plus a1 times 1 plus a2 times 1 squared equals 3. Then when we plug in x equals 2, we get a0 plus a1 times 2 plus a2 times 2 squared. Then we should get minus 1. And finally, if we plug in x equals 3, we get a0 plus a1 times 3 plus a2 times 3 squared equals 5. Okay, so the augmented matrix is 1, 1, 1, and 3, 1, 2, and 4, with a minus 1, and 1, 3, 9, and a 5. Okay, so now let's row reduce this thing, which is always what we end up doing. So we're going to row reduce this thing. Okay, so how does that start? We start with the top entry of the first non-zero column, and we use that entry to eliminate everything below it. We do that by taking row 2 and subtracting row 1. That's the new row 2. And similarly, the new row 3 is row 3 minus row 1. Then we get 1, 1, 1, and 3. That stays where it is. And 1 minus 1 is 0. 2 minus 1 is 1. 4 minus 1 is 3. Minus 1 minus 3 is minus 4. And the third row, 1 minus 1 is 0, 3 minus 1 is 2, 9 minus 1 is 8, 5 minus 3 is 2. Okay, good. Now we're going to move to this lower matrix down here. Perform the same kind of thing. We identify a pivot entry there, and we're going to use that to get rid of the 2 below that. So we're going to have a new row 3, which is the old row 3, minus 2 times row 2. So row 1 stays where it is, row 2 stays where it is, and we're taking row 3 minus 2 times row 2. So 2 minus 2 is 0. 8 minus 6 is 2. 2 minus twice minus 4 is, so 2 plus 8, that'll be 10. Okay, so now it's in row echelon form. And at this stage, we can deduce something about whether there are solutions and what kind of solution there's going to be. Is there going to be a unique solution? Is there going to be a one-parameter family solutions, two-parameter family solutions, so on. So what we can identify here is that there's going to be a single solution. A solution, we know that because the last column is not leading. Since the last column is not leading. And how many parameters are there going to be in the solution? Well, remember that the parameters correspond to the non-leading columns on the left-hand side. There are no non-leading columns on the left-hand side. What does that tell us about how many solutions there are going to be? There's going to be zero parameters in the solution because there are zero non-leading columns on the left-hand side. Zero parameters means that there's going to be a unique solution. So we can anticipate that already at this stage. We know that's where we're aiming for. There's going to be a unique solution, which is good because that'll give us a unique quadratic function that goes through the three points. Okay, so let's carry on now. And we're going to be doing this, this reverse kind of row reduction where we start from the bottom and work our way up. And we're aiming to get the matrix in reduced row echelon form. So that involves the leading entries being one and everything above the leading entries being all zeros. Okay, so let's carry on. So we're going to get rid of that two at the bottom. That's a leading entry. We want to make it one. So the new row three is going to be one half of the old row three. So we'll just divide that last row by two. So the first two rows stay where they are, and the last row becomes 0015. Great. And now we're going to do this sort of reverse thing where we start with this as a pivot entry, and we use it to get rid of the entries above it. So what's that? So the new row 2 is going to be the old row 2 minus 3 times row 3. And the new row 1 is going to be the old row 1 minus row 3. Okay, so now it's perhaps appropriate to start at the bottom because that stays where it is. The new row 2 is the old row 2 minus 3 times row 3. So 0, 1, 0. And minus 4 minus 3 times 5. So that's minus 19. And the first row, well, we have to just subtract the third row. So we get 1, 1, 0, and 3 minus 5 is minus 2. Great. And now our next pivot entry, we're going to go up one row to the second row, use that entry there to get rid of everything above it, to get rid of this 1 right here. Okay, so that's row 1 is going to be row 1 minus row 2. So what do we get? We get the bottom row stays where it is, 0, 0, 1, 5. The next row stays where it is, 0, 1, 0, minus 19. And the first row becomes, we'll just subtract the second row. So we get 1, 0, 0, and over here, minus 2, minus minus 19. That's minus 2 plus 19. Which is 17. Great. So this is now in reduced row echelon form. That's great. Because now we can just read off the solutions. Because the first equation is just a 0, which was our first variable corresponding to the first column, is 17. The second equation is that A1 is equal to minus 19. And the third equation is that A2 equals 5. So the required quadratic is y equals 17 minus 19x plus 5x squared. We have found a quadratic equation that passes through all of the required points. Okay, so let me show you how this works with MAPLE. Okay, so MAPLE is a computer algebra system, very powerful, from Canada. And I'm going to show you how to solve the little system here with just a few commands. So we're first of all starting with the linear algebra package, which is invoked with this command with linear algebra. And I put a colon here that doesn't show us what's happening. If I wanted to see in all gory detail, There we would, with a semicolon, we see all the various tools that are in that toolbox, okay? We're not going to use most of those, so we don't need that. Okay, so and then I've input this matrix M. There's various ways of doing that. I happen to use this left-hand panel here. And there is the matrix M. That's the matrix of coefficients that appears on the left-hand side of our system. And then we have the vector of the right-hand side, which is the vector 3 minus 1, 5. And this is the way you input a column vector with numbers separated by commas, and you get this column vector. And then I can put the matrix M and the vector V together like this to form a matrix A. So this is like the augmented matrix of the system. This is what we were starting with when we were working with my pen and paper. Okay, and now we can do the whole thing with one command, the command reduced row echelon form of A. So now the computer is going to go through the steps that we've just done, okay? And the point here is that, you know, we know what the computer has been doing. It's been doing basically the same thing that we just did, except it does it in a flash. And happily, it gets the same result that we do. And we can sort of verify that this is kind of reasonable by plotting. So I'm plotting 17 minus 19x plus 5x squared. And I have to give it a range, or I can't give it a range, say x equals 1 to 3 with two dots there. And then it will plot the function. There it is right there. And so this is the value 1 right here. The value 1, it has value 3. When x is 2, it's, you know, down at minus 1. And when x is 3, it's up at 5. So great, this this curve does look like it's going through the three points that we've talked about.